Greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. I have called you friends. John chapter 15, verse 13 and 15. Jesus does not ask me to die for him, but to lay down my life for him. Peter said to the Lord, I will lay down my life for your sake. And he meant it. John chapter 13, verse 37. He had a magnificent sense of the heroic. For us to be incapable of making this same statement Peter made would be a bad thing. Our sense of duty is only fully realized through our sense of heroism. Has the Lord ever asked you, will you lay down your life for my sake? John chapter 13, verse 38. It is much easier to die than to lay down your life day in and day out with the sense of the high calling of God. We are not made for the bright shining moments of life, but we have to work in the light of them in our everyday ways. There was only one bright shining moment in the life of Jesus, and that was on the Mount of Transfiguration. It was there that he emptied himself of his glory for the second time, and then came down into the demon-possessed valley. See Mark chapter 9, verse 1 to 29. For 33 years, Jesus laid down his life to do the will of his Father. By this we know love, because he laid down his life for us, and we also ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. 1 John chapter 3, verse 16. Yet it is contrary to our human nature to do so. If I am a friend of Jesus, I must deliberately and carefully lay down my life for him. It is a difficult thing to do, and thank God that it is. Salvation is easy for us because it costs God so much. But the exhibiting of salvation in my life is difficult. God saves a person, fills him with the Holy Spirit, and then says, in effect, now you work it out in your life and be faithful to me, even though the nature of everything around you is to cause you to be unfaithful. And Jesus says to us, I have called you friends. Remain faithful to your friend, and remember that his honor is at stake in your bodily life.